Hello everybody and welcome to another Transformers third party review. In today's video we're taking a look at the slightly ahead of schedule offering from Metagate. This is their first product that I've had a chance to review. They have already released the Drift triple changer figure, which looks outstanding, and I've heard very good things. This is of course their very highly anticipated take on Beast Wars Terrorsaur. I've just seen that they've already teased some more of the triple changes as well. God, this company is phenomenal with their engineering. Anyway, this was pretty much the exact face I pulled when I got this guy out of his packaging. Oof, indeed. He looks absolutely sublime. Up close and personal, let's just cast a bit of a shadow over there, just so you can see the levels of detailing on that face. The colour is superb. Not as accurate to screen, I don't think the colour is. Some of the early renders did look more kind of accurate, but they've managed to compress everything in with a pretty much screen accurate transformation as well. I mean, his feet become part of his wings, and his arms become his legs. It's crazy, really, but how good does he look? Now, because this was pre-production, it all came in a baggie as opposed to an actual box, but we get this stand. It looks like they're going to release more of these, which can then interlink. On the underside, we've got a long kind of sniper rifle with some lovely little red accents on there. We get his small pistol, two alternative faces, a kind of a grouchier looking one and a very kind of sadistic smirk. And then we get these as well. They just peg in to one another. They are his kind of shoulder blasters. I guess you can kind of put them on top. There's nowhere really to put them underneath. They kind of poke them through, but they don't sit as well as they should. But the idea is you can just pop those in. Which way did these go? These are ball mounted, aren't they? So it doesn't matter which one goes which side. So I should pop that in. And same on that side. I just have those up either side and terrorize. Those look kind of funky, don't they? The guns can just fit in his hands, as you would expect from any of these kind of modern MP style figures. We get that kind of T-like gap in the hands, and then we can bring those blasters in, and that's going to peg in, and then we can wrap those hands around them like so, and just pop that up. I love the double joint on those elbows, because it's almost kind of a James Bond pistol grip there. Gorgeous looking bot, isn't he? Backpack, yeah, there's a backpack. Considering what's kind of compressed in there, I think have done an exceptional job. Now in terms of a comparison, your obvious first choice for the comparison is the oversized version of Kingdom Terrorsaur. And then we can bring in some more Beast Wars Predacons to give you an idea of his size. And the same again with some Maximals. So that's definitely far more in keeping with that kind of masterpiece Beast Wars scale. Now let's take a look at the articulation. Head can look up, down, left, and right. These can actually rotate, so they're on ball sockets as well, so they're actually incredibly flexible. Change out the face, literally tilt the head back and flip this off from the front, tap that back in. Shoulders are on butterfly joints. They can come up to the side. This is an independent piece, so it can move so as not to hinder. There's an upper bicep rotation, double jointed bend on the elbows, rotation on the wrist, as well as a pivot, which is kind of part and parcel with the transformation. And we've already checked out those articulated hands. There is a bit of an ab rocker, but it's more of a kind of a rustly motion going on there because it's designed to tab in behind this chest piece. Emgo had the same problem. His kept popping out. Mine does as well. There is waist rotation. As you rotate the waist, it does tend to, the vibrations, I guess, are what makes this move. We have hip skirts to the rear. And we have these flaps to the front, which can allow the legs to come all the way forwards, all the way back. Really nice soft ratchet forwards and backwards. Out to the side. Again, step from here to here is probably a little more than I would like. I actually prefer a friction joint on there just to keep that stance a little bit more natural. Knees bend all the way around like so. We have up and down on those ankles, as well as some side rockers, although the rockers themselves are hindered slightly by this screw section. So, but still lots going on there. It's just like something a little bit less kind of aggressive on those thigh ratchets. But my goodness me, what a very stoic looking figure. Now before we get him transformed up, quick word from our sponsors. If you find these videos useful, why not head over to Showzee using the link in the description below. Before you make that purchase, head up to the top of the page on the support your favorite reviewer tab and type in Ben's. That'll help support the channel and keep these reviews coming. And we are back. Thanks to that, my lovelies. Those referrals do really help as well. Let's see. We get, I think it's something like 0.5 points or half a point or something like that for every dollar people spend. When the points all kind of build up, then I get more purchases in and get more stuff into review. Start off this transformation, you're going to want to unfold his little leg piece. This is going to rotate around so that a wrist is now facing this hole here, and with the hands collapsed, that's going to come in like so, and then this is going to rotate so it's facing like so. Do that with both hands. This panel slides down, the arm is going to rotate around like so until this socket is lined up. This comes down, rotates around, flips and sits inside that void. This is going to come untabbed from this back panel here. Oh, I love how this looks in beast mode. You wait, this comes up, there's this panel on the back of the head that lifts up like so, and this is going to come up for now. Let's just move these out like so. This is going to untab from here. This is going to lift. This is going to come down like so. This hinge is always so stiff. It's going to come out. This is going to come out. And this is going to come up. This is going to fold like so. And like so. And as you can see here, this is on a rotating mushroom peg, just supporting underneath these hinges so you don't apply any additional pressure. Bring that one round. So same on this side. Extend this from underneath. And just make that line up. this comes out, this comes out. Flip open this little piece here, applying pressure underneath here. Bring this all the way around, like so. This is gonna come out, like this, and just unfold this section like that. Look at that, all of that's just come from the inside of his torso. And if you look, that void that we've created here, the arm can rock and rotate and swing like so. So it all tucks up underneath there. Absolutely sublime. What a little joy. I love the fact that this entire frame which supports his torso is die cast. So anyway, undo his butt plug, just pop that out. That's gonna unfold like so, and that slides out. And as we slide that out, this is gonna shimmy down. It just kinda drops slightly lower on that crotch. This here, this is all one nice big die-cast panel. No weird looking screws or anything in there. It's in there and it's a solid piece. And from here, basically the legs are gonna form lower parts of the wings. So you're gonna wanna pull the kneecap down, come down to the back of the shin. That's gonna come down as well. This leg is gonna drop down into this void. So it rocks back and sits in there lovely like this. This is then gonna come over and fill said void. There is a little ditzy bit here which flips out like so. This is then going to, there we go. Unplug. And same on t'other side. Unplug, these come together and plug in to one another, like this. There we go. And then this is gonna fold in to that void. And once we've done that with both legs, you wanna bring this down, and we're looking for these to be square. And if you look here, look, you're gonna be in the way, aren't you? Just move you back, like so. There are some tabs here, and some tabs here. These are gonna line up, like so, there, come on, in you come. There, so that that sits in like that. Doesn't really wanna tab in there as nicely as I would have liked. His head is on this neck rocker. Make sure it rocks down. This is then gonna come through this void here. And there's a small groove in here that allows this to line up. Make sure this is outwards, like so. Because when this collapses like this, this basically needs to clear this crotch area. So you see that that's in, that's out, that's clear of there, like that. That's in there. When they're in, these are all gonna start sliding in to one another. This is gonna tab in here. There's these sections here. They tab onto the front of here. I've opened up the bottom just so you can kind of see how his head is meant to go. So you've got those two notches behind there. Make sure they're behind the head, that way that can sit down properly. And then I can just close this back up now, just so you could see what it was meant to kind of look like. And this is what we're dealing with on the underside here. That's gonna line up, that's gonna line up. It's not quite stretching as it should. There you go. There, that's better. Just give this a little tweak if this doesn't sit as it should. There we go. This is then gonna come down. You see we've got a tab on the back of the head which tabs in, and you've got this tab here. So it tabs in at those two points. And then this is gonna come up and over. And yeah, I'm not a fan of that sliding through there, really. sure there's a better way of doing this, but there's no instructions with these, so what you see is kind of what you get. So kind of just bring this over and work this piece kind of in between like that. Ah, there we go, and then it latches on to that underside like this, and then we can open up Terrorsaur's mouth and then just tidy up any pieces that we've kind of dislodged as I've been getting a bit rough and gruff with it. And then finally just bring this section around. There's a groove on back here that's going to come over, and that's going to sit and line up like so. There we go. We can just extend the claw like this. And then we get the base as well. Look at that. How sensational does that look? Air King in all of his glory. What a gorgeous sculpt on the beast form. Fantastic colours. But this neck joint, not brilliant. Not brilliant, really. Even like a little rotation or the ability to bring it further out. I think Emgo mentioned it in his. It's just a figure shouldn't get in its own way. And this one does. I think he kind of summarized that brilliantly. But yeah, that looks absolutely sublime. I mean, comparatively speaking, there's two very different ends of a budget there, isn't there? Yes, this one does look far more simplistic. It's just an oversized version of the Kingdom figure, but it's still a good Terrorsaur. Nothing takes that away from it. It's just that this one, they're just showing off, aren't they? And finally, here we have them in beast form as well. That's actually a really good scale. As you can see, I've got the rockets mounted to the top of him there. They just plug in, but yeah, they all look really good together. That's a great scale, a much better wingspan, and a really nice color. Goes especially well with kind of these vibrant colors of the beasties, don't they? I think they all look really good together. His metallic paint just kind of makes him pop just that little bit more though. Here we go, look. Really kind of fits in with his beastly comrades. Love how that looks. So there we have it, ladies and gentlemen. We've all been waiting for it. I think these are now hitting retail. So enjoy it when you get it. It's a gorgeous looking figure. The bot mode, in my opinion, is the best form. Transformation isn't overly complex. It's just a lot of panel folding, but it's very straightforward. A bit cautious of that neck area, but other than that, a superb figure, and it fills me with a lot of confidence for the Metagate team. I honestly cannot wait to fiddle around with some more of their figures. Huge thanks to Shozy for getting this early sample out to me, and until next time, myself and the rest of the collectibles household, thank you all very much for watching. Goodbye.